Along with my good friend Johnny, and the man behind the incredibly successful Peugeot Legend social media pages, Adam Riches, I'm off to the Nürburgring to compete in the VLN series in the new Peugeot 308 TCR car. Accompanying us on this journey, Peugeot UK have fittingly given us the new 308 GTI 270. This is essentially the road-going version of the car I'll be competing in at the Nürburgring. This is by far the fastest car ever to wear the Peugeot GTI badge, and should be the perfect companion as we embark on the 1,000-mile round trip to the Nürburgring. The first task for our 308 was to comfortably fit all of our luggage, which it did with ease. Next, it had to transport us in safety and comfort down to Dover, hopefully allowing us to arrive fresh with such a long journey in front of us. While my passengers slept, I enjoyed the quiet roads and got to know my new car for the weekend.
Feeling good. Feel refreshed.
When we left the ferry at Calais, we still had a 5-hour drive in front of us. Well aware that this was a car designed to be used on track, and now that they were awake, here was the time for the 308 to show my passengers how good it was at being a normal car. We arrived at the workshop of the Net Motorsport team. This is the first team to receive the 308 TCR race car, which will be used in the VLN series at the Nürburgring. The 308 race car shares much of its basic architecture with the road car, such as the same chassis, the same engine block, and a few shared components like door handles. There are a few differences though, as you can see from this video. The race car has 330 horsepower, slick tyres, and a big rear wing. It doesn't have much of an interior either.
The car is very stripped out, bare, very light, looks brilliant. Very scary around the ring.
Once my guests had enough time with the race car, we headed to the village of Adenau, which is near the Nürburgring, just about 10 miles from the team's workshop, to reflect on our journey so far. Next, we drove the 308 GTI through the mountain roads to one of my favourite spectating spots on the Nordschleife, the corner called Galgenkopf, which is just after the Kleiner Carousel. This is a spot where fans can get very close to the track, and an ideal place for my guests to get their first taste of Nürburgring action. Peugeot legend Adam even managed to get some pictures of the RCZ race car which will be competing this weekend. Finally, it was time to drive the 308 to our hotel and get some rest ahead of the race day. As the first race of the season, this was a really big event. 190 cars entered in the race, which was around 450 drivers. First thing in the morning, the mechanics made their final preparations before the racing began. Despite having done lots of laps of the Nürburgring in various different cars, this car was astonishing. The sheer amount of power going to the front wheels, the gear change, the way the car rides the curbs, everything felt just right. Qualifying now over, it was time to take up our place on the starting grid. As we wheeled the car into position, past various Porsches, Aston Martins and other supercars, it was impressive just how far this 1.6 litre hatchback had got itself up the grid. Thank you. the race began, and my guest watched as the car carved its way through the Eiffel Mountain circuit. Tomorrow it will be their turn to experience the Peugeot 308 GTI on the Nürburgring Nordschleife. Once the racing's finished, the Nürburgring returns to effectively being a public toll road. For €30, you can drive your normal car on the same piece of tarmac that was raced on just a day before. By now, we already knew the 308 GTI was a great road car. Now it was time to see whether this car could perform on circuit as well. The answer? Well, I'll let you watch this video and decide for yourselves. Driven all the way from the UK, and with absolutely no modifications, the 308 GTI was eating dedicated track cars for breakfast. Corner after corner after corner, no matter how late I braked, no matter how hard I pushed, the car just kept asking for more. By the end of the lap, my passengers were left in no doubt about the incredible ability of this car. After the brakes had cooled, we set off for England, with time to reflect upon a weekend in a brilliant car.
The key things you need to change to make it good as a track day car are already done.
Yes. There's none of this, so I'm not going to do it.
Yeah.
But if you pulled up in this, think about it's a nice car.
Yep.
I'm personally really pleased that it's kind of turned driving. It's easier in textbook, like Ford driving, Peugeot 8. Yeah, at least he respects it. Johnny's looking at the specs online.
Comfortable but fast, practical but wild, the 308 GTI was everything we needed it to be this weekend. As a true all-rounder, they don't come any better than this.